Hello, this is the first video in a series on SAS Viya deployment topologies. I'll be looking at the latest versions of SAS Viya. We will discuss some of the main differences from SAS Viya 3 deployments and cover the basics of deploying the latest versions of SAS Viya. So let's get started. SAS Viya the basics. The latest version of SAS Viya has been developed to be cloud native and easily deployed on the major cloud providers, starting with support with Microsoft Azure. SAS Viya now runs on Kubernetes, and the first support is for the Azure Kubernetes Service, or AKS. Support for the other cloud providers, the AWS Elastic Kubernetes Service, or Google's Kubernetes Engine, and Red Hat OpenShift will be coming soon. So there is no bare OS support with the latest version of SAS Viya. SAS Viya is now shipped as a set of container images. The new SAS Viya is continuously delivered with monthly updates. Two cadence options are available. There is the stable cadence, which delivers monthly. For example, stable 2020.1.3 was delivered in February, a few days ago. And the long-term support, or LTS cadence, is delivered 6 monthly. For example, the LTS version 2020.1 was delivered in November 2020. The LTS version 2021.1 is scheduled for May this year, and the LTS version 2021.2 is scheduled for November this year. See the SAS Technical Support Services and Policies page for more information on the cadence options and support levels. The URL is shown here. But first, before we start talking about the SAS Viya deployments, we need to understand a little about Kubernetes. And first, I'd like to talk about the concept of namespaces. So namespaces are a way to logically divide a Kubernetes cluster resources between multiple applications. Each SAS Viya deployment is associated with a Kubernetes namespace. But you can only have one SAS Viya deployment per namespace. Therefore, you could say that a SAS Viya deployment is a SAS environment which equals a namespace. You can have multiple namespaces or SAS Viya deployments in a single Kubernetes cluster. You can share or dedicate resources to each of the SAS Viya environments if you're sharing a cluster. The next Kubernetes concept that we need to understand is a pod, Kubernetes pods. So a pod is the smallest deployable compute object in Kubernetes. A pod encapsulates the application's container and the related storage resources. A pod can hold multiple containers, but usually contains a single container. Pods are hosted on the nodes, and Kubernetes will determine which node will host a pod. So controlling the deployment. By default, Kubernetes will randomly schedule the pods across the available Kubernetes nodes. This is not the best for applications with high resource demands like analytics platforms. While controlling the deployment by manually assigning pods to the Kubernetes nodes may not follow the ethos or core philosophy of Kubernetes, it is needed. We need this to ensure a predictable operating environment and to avoid resource conflicts. So how do we control the SAS Viya topology? Controlling the deployment. So how do we control the SAS Viya topology? To do this, we need a workload placement strategy or a workload placement plan. To create the workload placement plan, you need to understand the drivers for the platform design. For example, speed. Is performance the primary driver for the analytics environment? Or maybe it's availability. Is high availability the primary driver for the SaaS environment? Or perhaps it's cost. That platform cost should be kept to a minimum. Or maybe it's a mixture of two of these. I want the best performance at the lowest cost, or the best availability at the lowest cost. So we need to consider the approach to the environments when we create our workload placement plan. For example, will the SaaS environment share the Kubernetes cluster with other applications, or will there be a dedicated Kubernetes cluster for the SaaS software for the SaaS environment? Will multiple SaaS environments share the same Kubernetes cluster? For example, perhaps I've got a enterprise reporting environment and a separate or a second environment for our data scientists. Will these share the single Kubernetes cluster? So we need to define the approach to sharing. For example, will we have a shared cluster with all nodes shared across all environments or all applications? Will we have a shared cluster with some nodes dedicated to a SaaS environment? Or will we have a shared cluster with nodes dedicated to each SaaS environment? Getting started. So how do I get started, especially if your organization is new to using Kubernetes? I would use the default workload classes, taints, and tolerations. There are currently 5 workload classes defined. Ones for stateless, stateful, connect, compute, and CAS. There is a infrastructure as code, the SAS Viya Infrastructure as Code project in GitHub. And that is currently available for Microsoft Azure, but will be built out as the other platforms are supported. This provides Terraform scripts which will create the 5 node pools to support the workload classes seen above. This is what we could say is separation by tier. And the link to this project is shown here. Another thing that you need to consider is the approach to logging and monitoring with the Kubernetes environment. There is another GitHub project, the SAS Viya Monitoring for Kubernetes. And this is a good place to start. And again, the URL for this project is shown below. Getting started and keeping it simple. I would start with the default deployment and modify it from there. But the good news is a key difference between SAS Viya 3 and SAS Viya 4, the current version of SAS Viya, is that SAS Viya 4, that deployment is very easy to change. It doesn't require a reinstallation of the SAS Viya software to change the deployment topology. Therefore, start with a standard deployment. And here perhaps we've used the Terraform scripts, and we can see our Kubernetes cluster. And there's 5 different node pools here, which are dedicated to our SaaS software. So in Azure, when we set up a Kubernetes cluster, we can set up one or more node pool. And each node pool has a set of servers which are identical in there and provide the resources for running the application pods. So we've got our Viya namespace here, and we can see that our first node pool is for our stateless pods. Our stateful pods, we have a node pool for connect, compute, and CAS. On the right here, we can see a 6th node pool, which is for the third party or the required supporting applications to run the SAS Viya software. So you can start with this default topology and monitor the system and change the topology once you understand the resource consumptions and performance. I would also use the SAS Viya Monitoring for Kubernetes GitHub project to implement the logging and monitoring. That's a good way to start. And some of these components I've illustrated here on the side. If we are using this approach, here's a simple deployment, maybe starting with an SMP or MPP CAS server. I've called this separation by tier using the default node pools or the node labels. So when we create these node pools, we can actually assign a label to the nodes. So what we can see here is we're coming back to our Kubernetes cluster. We have our five different node pools. I haven't shown the third-party application node pool here. And we can see that the node pools have been dedicated to running the pods for our SAS Viya software. For example, node pool 1 has been given a label of stateful and has been dedicated to running the stateful prods. And here is the fully qualified class name for that, or the label for the stateful class as shown here. Node pool 2, this has been dedicated to running the stateless pods. So all our stateless application pods are running here on node pool 2. And once again, here is the label for the stateless nodes. 3, this node pool has been dedicated to running the connect pods. And 4, the node pool 4 here, this has been dedicated to running the compute pods. And finally, node pool 5 has been dedicated to running the CAS pods. So this separation by tier model here using the default labels. So using the default labels is ideal to get up and running with SAS Viya. The SMP CAS server is good for relatively small volumes of data and small numbers of users. Otherwise, use an MPP CAS server. If the order includes the micro analytics service, maybe it's a model manager order or the visual machine learning order, these pods are classed as stateless pods, and they would be deployed with all the other stateless pods. In addition to the labels, however, we can apply taints and tolerations, and these need to be defined if we want to strictly enforce the pod placement that we saw on the previous screen. And all nodes in a node pool need to have the same labels and taints. We can't mix and match those. Some final thoughts: that if you are going to enforce the strict rules or the strict placement rules, as we saw in the previous diagram, where a node pool is dedicated to a particular type of application pod, then you need to ensure that all the pods can be scheduled, or there is enough capacity there, if you like, to run all the pods for each of the SAS Viya environments running in the cluster. I would have at least one node pool and at least one node that does not have any taints on it, so that pods can go there as a worst case scenario, if you like. This provides a scheduling option should that preference for placement not be possible. For example, maybe we were trying to schedule another compute server pod, but the compute node pool was full and didn't have enough capacity to start another compute server pod. That wouldn't start. But if we've got a node pool for failover, if you like, because it doesn't have any taints or labels associated with it, then that would be able to start there. You also need to have those nodes for our non-SAS or supporting software. So have a third-party node pool. Finally, at the time of making this video, the following SAS Viya versions were available. The future releases may change some of the defaults that I discussed in this video. In the next video, we will look more deeply at the deployment topologies and how we can control them.